As you know, the city of Orlando is built on tourism. Known as the theme park capital of the world, the most visited destination in America never stops evolving. 2023 is destined to be a huge year for the travel industry in the City Beautiful. Making a trip from here to points like West Palm Beach, Fort Lauderdale, and Miami will be easier and faster than ever when high-speed train service makes its debut. The theme parks are adding new attractions, including two highly anticipated roller coasters. The city's premier performing arts venue has something new in the works, and hip, stylish hotels are popping up everywhere, giving you more lodging options for your next visit. On this episode, we're running down what's new in Orlando in 2023, some of the top experiences you might want to add to your list. All of that and so much more straight ahead from Central Florida. Brightline Orlando is scheduled to begin service during the second quarter of 2023. A 37,000 square foot train station will open inside Terminal C at Orlando International Airport. From there, passengers will be able to take the Brightline to destinations in South Florida. The train will travel at 125 miles per hour, with it taking around 2 hours to reach West Palm Beach. Visit GoBrightline.com for more information about this new exciting service. Tank America is an adventure park that puts visitors in the driver's seat of an FV-433 Abbott military tank. The half-mile course traverses jungle terrain and mud pits while letting adrenaline junkies lay waste to everything in their path. To learn more or to make a reservation, visit their website. TankAmerica.com. One of our favorite boutique hotels in downtown Winter Park is undergoing a major expansion. The existing 112 rooms and suites at the Alfond Inn at Rollins are receiving a major facelift. The expansion includes an additional 71 guest rooms and suites, a lobby cafe, plus a new fitness area along with a spa, which will have 7 treatment rooms. Work is expected to be completed later this summer. After years of construction and anticipation from theme park fans, Tron Light Cycle Run is scheduled to open at the Magic Kingdom early April. The ride, based on a Disney sci-fi film, is expected to be one of the fastest coasters the company has ever built. Here at Disney Springs, a casual restaurant that offers up a breezy beach house environment is expected to open later this year. Summer House on the Lake will put a gourmet spin on favorites like avocado toast and pizza. This eatery will have table service dining, a bakery, and a pretty extensive bar menu. SeaWorld Orlando plans to debut its 7th roller coaster this spring. The attraction will be the world's first so-called surf coaster. Elements include a dynamic surfing launch and wave jumping motions that simulate being on the ocean. At Universal City Walk, they have a state-of-the-art escape room experience featuring creative storytelling based on the blockbuster films Jurassic World and Back to the Future.
Meanwhile, over at Universal Studios, a new Minions-based attraction is scheduled to open this summer. It will combine innovative screen technology and gaming interactivity.
Visitors looking to stay near the Walt Disney World Resort, but not on property, will have a new option in fall of 2023. Conrad Orlando will boast more than 400 rooms, several dozen suites, and a few family suites minutes from the Disney gates. The hotel is the first phase of a much larger vacation oasis called Evermore Orlando Resort. The progressive community of Lake Nona will be adding a new hotel to its lineup this autumn. Six-story aloft hotel will have more than 200 rooms with a music theme. It's being constructed on Lake Nona Boulevard near Drive Shack. The Dr. Phillips Center is the City of Orlando's premier performing arts venue and one of our favorite places to catch a live show. The curtain will be going up on the facility's fourth indoor performance space in fall 2023. Judson's will be a dynamic music room that will host live performances with intimate cabaret-style seating. The room will be able to accommodate up to 150 guests. That's it, 10 brand new experiences in Orlando in 2023. Do you plan to visit Central Florida sometime this year? Let us know in the comments and tell us what you're hoping to do. We have travel tips, maps, and links to the places mentioned in our videos on our website, ChadGallivanter.com. Check it out for your trip planning needs. Hey, one last thing. We have a ton of content on Orlando and the rest of Central Florida in our YouTube archives. Take a look if you're planning a trip to the area. As always, thank you so much for watching. See you next time.